future.
We are the future.
The carbon free future.
The carbon free future.
Ending the torsions.
Ending the torsions.
Shutting down the pipeline.
Shutting down the pipelines.
Everywhere we go.
Everywhere we go.
People want to know.
People want to know.
Who we are.
Who we are.
So we tell. Reminder that they'll die of old age. We'll die of climate change.
They'll die of old age.
We'll die of climate change.
They'll die of old age.
We'll die of climate change.
They'll die of old age.
They'll die of old age.
They'll die of old age.
We'll die of climate change.
They'll die of old age.
We'll die of climate change.
All they hate that the traffic is blocked.
Yeah.
They hate it. They can't get up in the motor. If we wanted to, we could sit here for a whole 10 minutes and make them wait.
Address climate catastrophe, and you're all complicit. Another friendly reminder that downtown Toronto's financial district is the headquarters of 70% of the transnational corporation responsible for the hydra that is Canadian International Mining. Exploiting people and destroying the planet. Shame! But you, my friends, are a representation of a carbon-free future, a beautiful utopia, and an end to this bullshit! District out of the offices and onto the street and repent for your bourgeois morality. Now or never, we won't forgive and we won't forget. All right, marshals on the side. Marshals on the side here, please.
Come on, Turf, get the fuck out of my way, please.
As usual sucks!
As usual sucks!
Another friendly reminder here from your local neighborhood critical mass riders that business as usual will not be usual on a burning planet. No jobs on a burning planet, my friends of the financial district. Bear this in mind and crawl into your 800 pounds Egyptian cotton bed this evening.
Everyone, look at the hang of left foot forward. Next, you can try to climb on the race face.
your car and into the street, friends. And to boot, supporting now, TC Energy Corporation sleuthing in the interior of BC from the tar sands and their supposed project to further Canada as a global energy leader with none other than a $40 billion liquefied natural gas pipeline called Coastal GasLink. Shame! Like our earlier service announcement, this right here in Toronto is where one of TC Energy's corporate headquarters is. This $40 billion liquefied natural gas line is responsible for the clear cutting of unceded territory of the West U.S., especially the Southern Plan and the Gideon Plan, who have been fighting for decades now to preserve their land and rebuild.
Thank you.
muscles up there. Slow it down, tighten up.
Slow it down, tighten up.
Really clogging up the system here, folks. No business as usual. I said, everywhere we go.
Ending the tar sands.
Shutting down the pipeline.
Get on the northern line. Get on the northern line. Get on the northern line. Rock. Get on the northern line. Get on the northern line. Get on the northern line.
Happy global climate strike.
Get on the northern line. Get on the northern line.
Get on the northern line. Marshals on the side, thank you for
your service. Get on the northern line. Get on the northern line. What do you know about back? I put my money in the back. I still think it's good for that place. We have to go back. What do you know about back?
A Green New Deal means free public transit.
Free public transit.
Lots of union jobs, cause workers gotta build it.
Lots of union jobs, cause workers gotta build it.
A Green New Deal means free public transit. Lots of union jobs, cause workers gotta build it.
Lots of union jobs, cause workers gotta build it.
We are unstoppable, another world is possible. We are unstoppable, another world is possible.
We are unstoppable,
another world is possible. We are unstoppable. Another world is possible.
We are unstoppable. Another world is possible.
Happy climate strike week, folks. Thank you.
Carolina, folks. And the world is changing, so you should too. No more business for you.
Change is good!
Thank you. Christopher here has that. That's it.
Rob, Guy Ford single-handedly moving through best he can to remove all of the red tape revolutionary measures to preserve the Ontario ecosystem that are so important to preserving global climate now. But for this section, we're going to turn it over to Herman, who's with TTC Riders. Herman, there you are.
Most people think that when they take transit, they're customers, you know? That's the word they use, the same thing they do when the electricity goes off. Well, transit is more than something you pay for. Transit is should be a social right, the right to move or not to move, and have access to movement without having to pay for it. It should be like Medicare, it should be like libraries, it should be like elementary and secondary schooling and post-secondary as well. And interestingly enough, in all of those areas, when they brought in Medicare, and when they brought in, when they have more universal access to libraries, and all those kinds of rights, it fundamentally changed the nature of those things. The public health changed when Medicare came in. But libraries were universalized. It affected literacy, as did free public education. Free transit is part of that. So looking at climate change, transit is a particular component of addressing. If you look at about four or five different things, moving away from dependence on automobility to transit, public transit is an absolutely essential movement. It addresses not just life in the city, but addresses climate change and greenhouse gases, and it addresses questions of social equality as well.
Yeah.
All of these things together.
Yeah.
And as you very well know, there's a vicious movement right now to replace personal driving of certain kinds of internal combustion engines with ride-hailing, which is private, and what they call P3s, public-private partnerships. And even their vision of moving to electric cars isn't a question of simply changing from internal combustion. It's to flood the market just like they do with cars, which still will affect the environment and still affect climate change, even though in some ways it's a step forward. But what about free transit? Why don't we have free transit? It's obvious, because they don't pay for public transit. If you look at all the breakdowns we've seen in the TTC, the fact that certain neighborhoods are transit deserts, and you know that certain areas outside the city don't have access to public transit. In fact, there's a city called Innisfil, a town which is near Barrie, which has hired Uber to be Uber and Lyft to not to have instead of having public transit. What you need in order to have free transit is massive increasing of funding of public transit, and public transit then becomes the way we get along. And it means ending or limiting the role of cars and automobility on our streets. Otherwise, public transit doesn't work. Free public transit doesn't work. The second component is it requires oodles of funding. It means massively changing how the government raises money. Obviously, it means massive changes in taxes, but it also means massive changes in how they spend. As you know, unfortunately, it doesn't trickle down to bikes that much, but people who drive don't usually pay for the roads, that the infrastructure around it. But free public transit could only happen if we actually massively spent the massive amounts that we'd have to raise on infrastructure and public transit. And they're not doing that, and they're not going to do that, because the growth, if you know it, certainly in Toronto, of public transit, and there is some increase, is not necessarily going to help or affect working class neighborhoods in the city. And when it does, it only usually addresses people in the upper levels of the labor market and people in the lower levels of the labor market, people of color, poor people, and even people living in indigenous parts of the city. And of course, half of the indigenous people live in cities. It affects them. So TTC Riders is an organization which calls for massive increase of spending in transit, keeping it public, ending the attempts of Ford to actually control. I just want to say that the idea of free public transit is out there. It's been out there. It comes and goes. But we don't really have a strong mass movement around it. I urge a lot of you folks who are now building these wonderful movements, like today, what we did today, for me, I haven't done this yet. It was fantastic. To get involved in either TTC Riders or in Free Transit Toronto. It's very important. There's a network across the country of people who want to work on free transit. We're going to have a statement out before the election. But you'll note that really isn't featured in the election. The NDP, I think, has it in its platform as sort of an aside. But it's not something they're arguing for or organizing for. It's something we have to argue for and we have to fight for. And finally, is that if to actually change people's transit patterns, you also have to change other parts of society. And that has to do with where people work, which means capital investment in what jobs are like, and secondly, housing. What kind of housing is available? Not this mad rush. All the parties are saying how they're going to put money in people's pockets to buy private housing, but to have a situation where people of different incomes live together, but also decent public housing and cooperative housing, like they have in some European cities. All those things come together to make increased density possible and to make free public transit something that we can all have. Thanks. Thank you.
University for one last stop at Fronton University, so we can just hang tight here for 2 minutes. We have water and snacks with Christopher over here.
Everybody ready?
Woo. Hell yeah!
Let's go!
I don't
to take to the streets again.
Heck yeah.
This is Critical Mass, Ride for the Climate. Off the sidewalks and into the streets, ladies and gentlemen. It's a beautiful day to shut it down. It's a beautiful day to kick off your climate strike. To clog out those pipelines, delivering dirty tar sands, oil, globally, here in town. A As
we all know, you can't be a climate leader and buy a pipeline. Shame on Trudeau, ladies and gentlemen. Did you know that you're a proud owner of a pipeline? Did you? Slow it down, folks. Tighten up. Shut down the streets of Toronto in recognition of the climate strike happening tomorrow. Don't go to work. Don't go to school. Don't buy any more shit. Get out into the streets, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to shut it down. Our time is up. They'll die of old age. We'll die of climate change, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to change something about this world that we're living in. Wake up. Wake up. As you may or may not know, Toronto is home to 75% of the world's mining corporations. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Your supposedly climate-leading Canadian nation-state is complicit in the extraction of rare earth and fossil fuels being shipped globally, sending us all into a drastic situation, an oblivion hurtling towards certain destruction. But you can do something, folks. Participate in your friendly neighborhood climate strike. We're here to remind you that tomorrow we'll be shutting it down, just like we're shutting it down today. Trudeau is neither. Can't buy a pipeline and be a climate leader. Progressive, anti-racist. Trudeau is neither. Suited up for free transit today, folks. As we just heard at Queen Park, free transit is an integral part of a carbon neutral future. Zero carbon now, zero carbon yesterday, zero carbon forever. Time's up, time's up. All out for climate strike. That's right, folks, it doesn't take much to disrupt business as usual. Just some friendly neighborhood climate strikers having a lovely Thursday afternoon bike ride right here down University Avenue. Join us. No more business as usual, folks. It's time to turn it around. Some say 10 years, some say 12. The reality is it all should have changed yesterday, ladies and gentlemen. It's been too long. It's all too much. Climate strike for the future. Fridays for the future. Everywhere we go,
much, folks. This rowdy, beautiful band of people clogging up the streets of Toronto for the climate strike. Just like we'd like to clog up those pipelines delivering dirty tar sands oil around the world. Just another Thursday, interrupting business as usual here in downtown Toronto, one of the mining and extraction capitals of the world. Time to face your publicity with climate catastrophe. Time's up. Forests burn and oceans die. All they do is lie, lie, lie. Forests burn and oceans die. All they do is lie, lie, lie. Forests burn and oceans die. All they do is lie, lie, lie. Forests burn and oceans die. All they do is lie, 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 lie.
Tell them.
yourselves to the rush hour crowd. Free transit. Very important message. Circle up, folks. That's right, folks. They'll die of old age and we'll die of climate change. And that's why, right here, in the midst of rush hour, we're going to show what exactly that's going to look like. And end to business as usual. Circle up your bikes. Don't be afraid. It's just a little die-in. Borrowing a beautiful concept from the ACT UP movement, the AIDS Coalition to Unleash Power. That's right. Folks, we are going to suggest that you lie, if you are comfortable doing so, face down so your beautiful messages on the back of these Tyvek suits can be visible to all of those hovering over and above.
Shame! Instead of cleaning up the mercury in the river, the Ontario government did nothing and sat on its hands. Decades went by and mercury poisoning became increasingly prevalent in the community, and they demanded continual action and nothing happened.
Shame!
But the community mobilized. Two separate sites have been located on the land near Grassy Narrows that have mercury levels of 80 times the safe levels.
Shame!
And our governments once again have done nothing. Wynn earmarked some money, but wasn't around long enough to see it through. Ford doesn't give two fucks. And the Trudeau Liberals are deciding to pinch pennies and play coy with building a mercury care home in their community, delaying much-needed services to the community. I cannot stress enough that this is a climate issue. Indigenous peoples are at the forefront of resisting climate catastrophe. With all the discussion on the Green New Deal and green jobs, it's important to remember that Indigenous peoples are already doing this work, unpaid. The labor of environmental stewardship that Indigenous peoples have taken on for centuries is one that must be recognized and held up in the debate about climate justice. The linkages between climate justice, Indigenous justice, migrant justice, racial and gender justice, and disability justice, these linkages must be forged. We cannot trust the government to take the action that we need. We cannot trust the courts, nor politicians, nor CEOs. But we can trust each other. It takes courage, and it takes strategy, and it takes intention. Momentary unity is not enough. We are unified here today for climate justice. But what happens when we go home? Do we simply wait for the next call to come out? Today we occupy this space as a collective. But do we revert back to individuals when we leave here today?
No!
We must do the work of building trust and accountability to each other. We must build power. We must build a critical mass. We must become friends, comrades, lovers, and accomplices. We must build communities that will not wait for a solution in the future, but that will build a solution right fucking now. We are quite literally running out of time. So today, talk to somebody you don't know. Ask them what climate justice means to them. Ask them what made them angry or they made them sad hearing about it. Exchange contact information. Get in touch. Meet up tomorrow at the Climate Justice Climate Strike March. Find like-minded people, form organizations, and take direct action.
Yeah!
Relationships are the building blocks of the revolution. So get talking, get organized, and get to work. Where colonial governments and capitalism fail, we must succeed. There is no other option.
Give it up for Carl! Give it up for yourselves! Give it up for each other! Everyday acts like this of shutting it down and building new relations. Take your time. Thanks for the solidarity honks, folks. You can exit your cars and introduce yourselves to each other. We're sorry to interrupt business as usual, but we're just building a revolution here, folks. Just busy building a revolution. No more business as usual. Woo!
time before we get up off of this ground. System change, not climate change.
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 Okay, folks, take your time. Right over here, near the direction of the green peas sign. Take your time and move slowly. Total system change doesn't require.
Climate is changing.
So why are we?
Stay on the beat, folks. Stay on the beat.
Changing. So why aren't we?
The climate is changing.
So why aren't we?
The climate is changing.
Hello, folks. Thank you so much for all your beautiful presence today. We are going to go up York Street right here, hang a left onto Wellington. There's a park at Wellington and Spadina. We'll rendezvous there, shed suits, exchange phone numbers, etc., etc. I love you all.
Way to go, we're keeping each other safe and shutting it down in rush hour! Woo! This time you're doing it. You can join us through the sidelines, off the sidewalks, into the street. It is time for a total system change. Out of your schools, out of the humdrum everyday life that is petro-capitalism. It's time for total change. Make friends, make lovers. Oh, I love you, Carl. Bikes on climate strike, queers against fossil fuels.
Safety, building new social relations, building new systems of trust, love, care, and accountability. It's an easy work, but we're out here doing it on the daily, folks. All right, folks, we're going to move through. You can't buy a pipeline and be a climate leader. Progressive anti-racist, Trudeau is neither. You can't buy a pipeline and be a climate leader. Progressive anti-racist, Trudeau is neither. You can't buy a pipeline and be a climate leader. Progressive anti-racist, Trudeau is neither. Unmasking the truth about Justin Trudeau. No reconciliation without a return of the lands. No truth without an end to broken promises. Shut down the tar sands. End the purchase of pipelines with public dollars. Indigenous sovereignty or bust, folks.
Divest from fossil fuels, invest in transit.
Divest from fossil fuels, invest in transit. Divest from fossil fuels, invest in transit. Divest from fossil fuels, invest in transit. Divest from fossil fuels, invest in transit. Can I get an amen? We're coming up, folks. Thursday's shutting it down, slowing down the flow of traffic. Just to remind you, the future can't wait. It is today.
Thank you.
That's right. A little bit of togetherness and a whole lot of love can bring business as usual to a halt. Keep on moving through the intersection here, folks. Follow Dolly. Lower down and tighten up a teeny weeny bit. The stop sign means stop burning oil, slow down the bicycles.
On the same boat with a lot of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in and the tide's gonna turn.
Well, folks, arriving to beautiful, beautiful destination. Y'all looking real cute. Let's bring it back into the center here. We are unstoppable. Another world is possible. We are unstoppable. Another world is possible. We are unstoppable.
Another world is possible.
We are unstoppable. Another world is possible. We are unstoppable.
You thought it was over.
We will collect the suits and the signs.